There are various types of glass depending on their uses, but there are roughly two types of glass that we should be aware of in terms of car windows. Compared to regular glass, which easily shatters into sharp shards when broken, tempered glass is over 10 times stronger and does not break easily. However, if it does break, it shatters into small granular pieces. There is also laminated glass, which consists of two layers of glass and a layer of plastic materials in between. Even if it does break, the glass will not shatter as it is held in place by the plastic layer. These days, cars come with tempered glass as a standard, and laminated glass is used partially. Laminated glass has been applied as a standard for front windshields for quite some time. The main purpose is to ensure passenger safety. The secondary purpose of laminated glass is to prevent or delay theft of valuable items in the car, and it can also provide some soundproofing effect. Volvo currently applies laminated glasses and tempered glass differently. Therefore, in collision test, tempered glass shatters into small pieces while laminated glass only produced glass fragments. Sunroofs are also made of double-layered glass, so in case of sunroof explosion during driving that occasionally appear in the news are unlikely to occur in Volvo vehicles. The application of double-layered laminated glasses may vary by model, year, and trim level. Therefore, to check what type of glass is used in the side windows of your car, you can simply look at the corner of the window. If there is a hammer symbol as shown above, it means that Volvo has used double-layered glass for that window. There are also many other markings that have significant meanings, but it may not be necessary to know all of them. Alternatively, you can lower the window slightly and check the cross sections to confirm. You will know it as soon as you see it. While it is true that double laminated glass is a good glass that enhances the safety and calmness, there have been concerns raised about it in recent times. The concern regarding laminated glass is that it may cause a delay in receiving external assistance or in passengers escaping from the vehicle in the event of an accident. Traditional tools used to break tempered glass are not effective on laminated glass.
But the problem is, safety glass is good, but for automobile submersions, it can be dangerous. It's because that tool you may have in your car doesn't work on this type of glass. It won't break it. Take a look for yourself. The hammer easily breaks a window with tempered glass, but look when they tried it on the laminate.
Well, you might be in trouble. It's not as easy as you think sometimes.
Which could potentially compromise rescue or escape efforts in an emergency situation. However, there is no specific recommendation or solution for dealing with laminated glass in such situations. If a person inside the car is unconscious and cannot open the door, breaking the glass to gain access may take longer or require the specialized equipment. This is considered the only drawback of laminated glass.
Come on, come on out, come on out, come on. Come on, come on. Pull, 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 pull. Come on.